Marshall McLeod, known as Fire, has come a long way as an outstanding amateur boxer. After only 1 year of competition, she ranked at number 2 in the nation in 2003 at 110 pounds. Afterwards, she went on to win the New York Metro Championships 2 times, the Empire State Games 3 times, New York Golden Glove Championships 3 times, and won a world title for Ringside Championship. Fire stands tall at an amazing 5'8", in a division where the average height is about 5'3". This gives Fire a boxer's advantage, and she knows how to use it. Tall, lean, and slick is what defines Fire, and she got skills to go with that. She has taken her boxing amateur career as far as she can with amazing results. She is looking forward to making her professional debut sometime this year. Fire is also a professional actress and model. She has appeared in over 15 films, television, hit show Law & Order, 8 commercials, and dozens of music videos. She is currently in collaboration with a full feature film starring herself portraying a boxer who wants to pursue modeling.
And I went to a gym and I actually had a free pass to train with a trainer, a boxing trainer. And I'm like, okay, all right, whatever. And I tried it. And then once I tried it, you know, when it went by, and it was actually an hour. So that's what I decided to box as a way to get the time to go by and to keep in shape that way. And then a coach came by. He'd been watching me, you know, train, and he just asked me a few questions about my work ethics and training. And then I just told him, he's like, oh, I can make you a champion. Why don't you come train with my girls? And then I came and I did it, and I said, all right, I'll be a boxer and I'll compete. And that's how it went from there.
I saw Fire about 4 years ago, maybe 5 years ago. She was training at one of the boxing gyms. And even though I knew she was in the fighter, I was looking at her work ethic and, you know, her natural rhythm coordination and also her stature, the way she was built. And after watching her for maybe 2 or 3 weeks, just sitting back training with people, every now and then glancing over, watching her work the bag or whatever, and seeing the dedication she had not even being a fighter, I approached her, and I rarely do that. Anyone who knows me know that I don't really approach fighters, and I don't approach prospects, but I came to her and I said, look, are you competing? And she said, no, I'm basically here just training for a movie role, a movie part. And I said, all right, I know you don't compete. Have you ever thought about competing? She says, no, not really. I said, I make a deal with you. Come train with me, and I guarantee you, I'll make you a champion. I said, because you have the attributes, you have the potential to be a champion. And in less than a year, she's a champion.
Fire is respected by some of the best fighters in the world. Paul the Magic Man, Mike Tyson, and Shane Mosley.
The way male boxers treat me, pretty much equal. I've never really experienced any kind of negativity towards me being a female boxer. I get just pretty much the same amount of respect that I get as if I was a male boxer.
What you need to do is learn the tricks of the trade. Go to work, put it down, and then get paid. If only 2 of us don't get caught for making a sale. I'm one, and if you the other, bro, I can't tell. Ain't nobody that can come in and get in the zone. Trying to kill 4 birds with about 15 stones. The C stands for Cool Breeze, who's known as the champ. Freddy Calhoun, the coolest cutter at camp.
Hey, my ones and my twos got your whole town shook. You better listen to your corner and watch for the hook.
The C stands for Cool Breeze, who's known as the champ. Freddy Calhoun, the coolest cutter at camp.
Hey, my ones and my twos got your whole town shook. You better listen to your corner and watch for the hook.
And when I first met Keisha, we argued for about 10 minutes. She wanted to fight me, really wanted to fight me. I look at this little person like, is you serious? And she had no back down. No back down, yo. So she got to be a great champion. She's going to be a great champion. Well, she won the gloves like, what, twice already? Three times. I'm sorry. I made a mistake. She's a nice person. She's going to be a great champion.
Golden Gloves is the most prestigious tournament in America. Every state has their own Golden Gloves, but the New York Golden Gloves is the only tournament where when you win, they give you an actual pair of Golden Gloves that are, you know, real gloves, and they're solid. And has a little diamond in the front. I've won 3 times, 3 years in a row, so I have 3 of them.
I watch her train. I'm here like Monday, Wednesdays when she's here, Saturdays. I think I'm here to support her. So of course I'm here. I'm nervous when Fire fights because she's pretty much a champion. She knows what she's doing. I'm pretty much kind of nervous for the opposition, actually. I would describe Fire's boxing as very like stylish, very fast moving, very like very organized. It's also very kind of like a sign of the times, and she's very like. She's like 10 boxes in one. It's like everything. She's complete package. So I've only been watching women's boxing for a while, but I haven't seen anybody even come close to her. Even if, you know, we weren't a couple, I would still have the same statement.
Floyd Mayweather Jr. He's hot. And these are the gloves that he signed for me. He signed both of them, actually. My most prized possession. Boxing has opened up some doors for me as for my other career, what I do professionally, which is acting and modeling. Like right now I'm working on a film called Kimberly Square Ring, and I've gotten to that film only because I was a boxer, and the writer and the director, he works out at the same gym as I work out. So he came up to me and then he said, I think it would be perfect for this role that I want to write. And he ended up writing the script around me. So, you know, in that aspect, that's helped me out. Doing photo shoots, you know, there's a lot of scouts coming out the gym, wanting some female boxers. And sometimes I just so happen to be there and they'll ask me if I would do this job. And I'll do it for them. And then it gives me some exposure, a little money in my pocket because amateur boxing do not pay the bills. And, so it's opened up a lot of doors for me in that aspect.
Somebody let me hold it, number two films because they test. Somebody let me hold it, number two films because they test. I fly through the night. Yeah, mixing hard with some Sprite. Lyrics we put inside ya. Listen to these ATL riders. Keep your head straight.